Exciting times are ahead. It's a complete ending of one situation so that something new can grow. Let's get into it. Hello, everyone. It's Michelle Patterson here with Angel Souls, and this is our weekly angelic message for the week beginning March 11th, 2019. This week for the auto, right, we had Archangel Raziel come in. So if you don't know who Raziel is, he is known as the Archangel of Mysteries, Wisdom. I always find him to be very electrical. So he, to me, feels to have almost like a very Uranian kind of energy, but everyone perceives him differently. But he has come through, and we have some interesting messages here to get into. So to begin, here we go. Have you learned what you are truly made of? Our true nature. It's about that this week. And they'll explain here, this is just them helping our human brains understand time. Time is not linear for them. So when we do these weekly readings, we're honing in on one little fraction of time and trying to harness it. So please understand, you know, it's the best we can do as humans. It's not going to be, you know, we can't really get all the information just by taking a little slice of it. Do you understand what I'm saying? So anyway, they explain that here. So this is a time, if we narrow in on time at all, see, that's what they're talking about. For you to understand your own inner mysteries. For all perception of your nature and your power is as of a small child, as if a small child were explaining the meaning of life. It's not quite on target, but beautiful to watch. So I think that's the kind of energy, again, knowing that it's going to be very difficult to kind of hone in on one time period, but we've been doing it for years, right? So we're doing our best here. But this is a time to look at, what are we really made of? What makes us tick? How are we as magnetic beings, okay? So this gets into sort of what's the quantum physics explanation, not only of the universe, but our part in the universe. So I think a lot of people are going to be looking that way. Think Nikola Tesla, universal blueprints, numbers. I'm surprised Archangel Metatron didn't come forward, you know, sacred geometry, all of those things. So that feels like the turn that we were taking, and that's going to help us understand ourselves. And, and they're talking about our understanding of our place in this world, our understanding of spirituality is just like a five-year-old trying to explain the meaning of life. Like we're onto something, but we're not quite understanding it to the depth that we could, all right? So we might have a little bit of growth in that area this week. It is the time to accept your abundance. That's nice, right? Let this be a time of ease and completion. Take the rewards as they come with great appreciation. Be comfortable as things come together. Focus on learning your own true nature. With love, Archangel Raziel. So again, we know Mercury is retrograde for a lot of this month, so it's not a time to push, but to sort of reevaluate. And try not to overanalyze or overconceptualize certain... I'm trying to like take this feeling and put it into words. Basically, don't try to put a nice, neat little story around your spiritual experiences, because that's what we all do. And I'm guilty of that. I've done that in the past as I was, you know, going on my journey and awakening and my ascension process. I would try to put nice, neat little meanings around things. And I was wrong. I was wrong. And back then, you know, I was basing my life decisions on what I thought the message meant. This is an ease and a free flow. So as something comes to you, sit with it, okay? Sit with it and see what direction it's going in. And they're even saying right now, when it is 100% the right direction for you to go in, it feels free-flowing. It's easy. It is the path of least resistance. So this very much feels like a time of letting things come to their natural conclusion, right? And feeling out how you truly want to move forward, not what the spiritual community tells you moving forward looks like. You're really letting things filter through you. You're getting to know your true nature. So that's kind of cool. Let's get on to the cards. So that was an interesting message coming up. I'm curious to see what happens with that and how that unfolds. If you are someone who constantly just skips ahead to the cards because you think that's where the reading begins, you are missing half of the message, all right? Please do not skip ahead. Watch until the end. The whole thing is a message. Also, please remember that these are general readings. So if you want something that is specific to you, you would have to get a personal reading. If you decide that I'm the right reader to give you that reading, you can go to my website, angelsouls444.com, the services tab. I'll tune into your energy to help you out. So it really, I mean, with these readings, you kind of get somebody to hear you, right? And to feel you and to understand you. And then, of course, you're getting your angelic guidance as well. I will be putting up, I think the next course that I'm going to do for Gumroad will be invoking angels. It might be a while before I put that up, though, but I'll keep you posted. And, of course, a special thank you to everybody who supports me on Patreon. I leave all that information down below. One more announcement. I will be answering your questions in videos. So I did a post on Facebook asking, you know, what kind of questions would you like to see me address within a video? And I was amazed. I've asked that question before and the feedback was not always, it was always a little like, huh? You know, it was either a personal question specific to them, they were trying to get a personal reading, or it was something I'd already, you know, covered numerous times in a video. So I was like, I don't know if I want to make a whole other video on it. But you guys really came up with some phenomenal questions. So I will be recording the answer to those. If you want to submit a question for me to address, please know that I will be saying your name in the video. I'll be giving you a shout out and you can leave that information down below. All right. In the comments section. Cool. I think that's it. Got so many things going on right now. So the first card we have out here is Five of Air, an unwise choice. Learn what you can from the situation. Review everyone's motives. So this card definitely is, I think you guys are really revamping your choices and going back over. You see where you have been overly analytical. And if you listen to the auto write message, it does talk about, you know, kind of easing into your abundance, easing into an understanding of who you really are and how you function, right? Not just on a mental level, which this does kind of indicate the mental body, but really getting ourselves lots of lamps on. It's a cloudy day, so I have all my lamps on. Right? I'm still going to have to color correct to make it work, but this is overthinking something and not spreading into your power. So when we're too much up in our intellect, we aren't in our heart wisdom. And when you're not, when you don't have those two things connected, you're not at full capacity. And I think that's what this is talking about. So if you feel like there's a lot of confusion, fear, conflict, whatever the case may be, just relax. Just step back and relax and make sure you are completely connected on all layers of your body. And you're going to watch as things kind of fall into place, solutions come up. You know what I'm saying? So don't try so hard, all right? Don't try so hard. All right, so the next, another air card. Okay, so we have 10 of air, the end of a difficult situation, embrace the change and expect things to get better now, recovering from an addiction. I mean, this again, we're realizing that the way we have approached our lives is just not working anymore. And oops, sorry. Now I gotta watch my little monitor and make sure there's no glare on the cards again, sorry. But you know it's done. It's done, it's over, but this is the end of stress. This is the chance to just finally put things to rest, to take a different approach, to allow yourself to enjoy your life now, not when this, and this comes together, or when I get that project done, then I'll be okay. This is all getting out of our heads. That's what a big part of this message is for this week, especially the Five of Air and the Ten of Air. I mean, it's done, okay? Done. All right? This is also, I feel like, the end of expectation on you. So if you are somebody who, I'm trying to think of an example. Let's just say you started your own business. Okay. And it was going well. Now it's not. And you're like, oh, you know, I don't know what else to do. It has to be this way. That was the plan. It has to go this way, this way, this way. You realize, okay, you can't go in that direction anymore. It's done, but it's not over. You know what I'm saying? Like there's a new approach. There's a fresh way, a fresh perspective that will help you get some inspiration to keep going, but on a different path. So for some of you, again, this is just a general reading. It's meant just to be a sample, right? To show you. But this generalized energy is one where we're realizing that we've gotten ourselves down a dark hall and somebody sealed it off, right? And we did that because we were overthinking, overstressing, pushing too hard, trying to be perfectionistic. Yes. And this is the week where, first of all, I think for some of you, you're just gonna be like, I just can't, I'm just tired. I kind of had a moment like that. My apartment is a disaster because it is, I can't do everything, right? And my apartment is kind of taking a hit. And I was like, you know what? I'm just going to release. I'm going to get done whatever I can get done. And I'm just going to do things to the point where I'm still enjoying it. But these two cards here really make me feel like people are like, too many lists, too much over planning. I got to do this. And there's this pressure. And now you're cracking. It's not necessarily a bad thing. It's the kind of cracking that releases. Okay. I'm really inarticulate today. I am so sorry. I've had to re-record this about 3 times, not with the cards, but just like the intro and stuff, because I kept tripping over my words. What can you do? Sorry. You guys know me well enough. I'll just keep it real for you. A time of positive change, a situation suddenly moves forward. Fortune is on your side. So whatever goes away, maybe it's this week, or maybe you just start getting a feeling this week that things are falling away. Don't hang on to it. I've seen people hang on to relationships that are no good for them just because they're used to it, right? That's the only reason why they're hanging on, because they're just used to it. Sorry, my set was falling apart behind me. My pillow was falling down. The whole bit, I had to fix it. Anyway, we're talking about the Wheel, Archangel Michael, fortune being on your side, and things are starting to move in a positive direction. So really, again, remember we were talking about in the auto right, understanding your true nature, understanding your frequency. I've been highly recommending the book Frequency by Penny Pierce. Love her. I love that book so much. And that will help you out a lot and understand, I think, kind of what the message is here. But in order to move forward, you have to be willing to let go. All right. Something's done. Something is done. And we as humans, we want to know, what does that mean? Does that mean my career is done? Does that mean this relationship is done? Does that mean my health issues are finally over? maybe, but this is deeper than that, guys. It's far deeper than that. This is maybe on a worldwide stage, we start seeing things start to move in a more positive direction, where you just keep trying to push on. So think of something that constantly breaks and you keep repairing it, and then it breaks again, and then you keep repairing it, and then it breaks one more time, and you're like, it's done. I'm going to recycle it now. it's out of my life. And finally, this burden is lifted off your shoulders, because you might have even gotten programmed and ready to fix things when they break, whether it's a relationship, your career, whatever. And now that it's off your plate, now you can create something new. And I think that's really what this is talking about. Okay. So the final card we have for the color card, oh my gosh, lots of change. We've got 2 fives here, guys. Lots of change. Check that out. So this one is 5 of Fire, competing goals, bothersome details, conflict with others. So again, this is kind of the transition period, I feel. So all this change is happening. I'm just going to fling these back up. All this change is happening. All these realizations are occurring. And this might find some of you literally being fired up. This is the fire. It's 5 of Fire. So being fired up, being passionate about something. But this also talks about overcorrecting. Yes? So, oh gosh, I'm so free of that career. Now I'm going to take on 5 other businesses. Right? Don't do that. Right? Or now, I finally found my voice. So now I'm going to go around telling everybody off. That actually is a natural, and check with a psychologist, of course, but I feel that that's a natural reaction when someone has been oppressed. These are people who are in abuse recovery usually. When they find their voice, they actually, it's like the dam breaks and they can't hold back anymore because they have had to be quiet for so long. So let's not just automatically hate on somebody who we deem is being negative. Sometimes someone is going through this transition of recovery and just trying to find their voice and swimming around in the tide for a little bit. But this 5 of Fire just says, don't overcorrect. Don't get too fired up. Now is not the time to go fighting for justice necessarily for some of you. So, yeah. There, this could be too with all these cards. There's a repeat of something that you thought was done and it's coming back again, astrologically speaking. That's kind of the energy that we're in right now. Literally, the day Mercury went retrograde, they started to repaint. They just painted my whole apartment complex. They're painting it again, a different color. I don't know why, but now we're all going to be painted into our apartments for the second time. So it's that kind of thing where it's kind of annoying and you don't know why it's happening. I mean, it's not like, it's not that exact scenario, right? But there's change in the air. Things are snapping off. I just heard abrupt endings as well. Some of you want to be very, very cautious, take extra care with your homes. Safety first on all levels. Some of you, okay, hold on, let me just get this because changing location. Hold on. Okay. Sorry for the long pause, but fire dangers. And I know people get so upset. I get people going, oh my gosh, you're just talking about scary stuff in the world. Don't let everybody else do the heavy lifting. I mean, we all got to be in this together. And this is coming up as kind of a, not a warning. I don't think it's like imminent, but there's something around location and fires and people relocating. Let me get this. Oh, okay. So places that have already been affected by fire. Okay. Everybody hang tight, okay? Places that have already been affected by fires. Some of you are getting to come home again. Some of you, and this might have been from like months ago, where there's finally a recovery. Now, the land's not going to recover. It takes decades for, that to happen. But people are returning to their homes with a heightened awareness around this, around the safety of the home. So I want to put that out there, okay? So please don't do that thing where you just want to automatically shut it down and say, oh, this is scary, this is negative, you make me feel bad. Well, you got a long way to go. You got a long way to go if you're doing that. Please don't. Please don't. We got to be in this together. So I think it's like fire awareness. Hi, firemen out there. Thank you so much. Firemen are my favorite. Sorry, maybe not just for like the rescue portion of it, but because they're cute. Something about a hero, All right, let's get to the color card here. Let's see what else we have going on. Rejuvenation comes with this too. They're not letting this go. Rejuvenation. So, yeah, when things, cleansing fire kind of thing, now there's this chance to rebuild. Of course, there are going to be things going on in the world. I mean, there's just no way around that. But it's forcing change. It's forcing us to look at different safety standards, and people are getting used to a new normal kind of thing. It's not bad. We're adjusting, okay? More about the earth. I'm not even going to read the words just yet, but look, there's more earth. And we just said, regeneration, and here's new growth. That's what's happening. So we can take that metaphorically, like our lives are kind of shutting down and then something new is coming out of it. But if you're one of those people, I'm telling you, if you're one of those people and you're just like, oh, I resist everything, you're going to have a bad time, okay? Don't do it to yourself. All right, brown, establish boundaries. The number is 12. Okay, so 12 is kind of like, high noon, okay? The time is here and it's getting back to basics. It's getting back to your roots, and it's trying again. That's something new is being not launched at this time. Remember, it's not the right time for that, but you're having a fresh start in one way or another. So again, tide is turning, things are ending. Don't freak out. Some of you are getting to come home, but there need to be changes around. Sorry to keep hanging on to this. Building materials. There's changes to building materials. Designing buildings that are a little more earthquake friendly, or people deciding to build further away from water, there's a lot of changes around homes. And again, what we choose and what building materials are doing to the earth. Huh. I can't wait to see how that plays out. But we could do this all day, but we're going to leave it there. I'm sending you all so much love and take care.